Here is an animation technique that, oh no, what is going on here? This problem is a bit like an orchestra with a genius conductor, but the musicians are useless, inflatable tube men. Okay, so we need a new AI animation technique that we can control properly. Now, I am not saying that animated movie and video game characters can't walk. Of course they can, although not so sure about this one. Now, these classical animation techniques are produced for every single motion by an artist. However, AI-based techniques offer something incredible. Just taking a soup of motion-captured animations and learning how to use them and weave them together. But there is a problem. The AI-based animation techniques that are controllable often fail to create physically viable motion. And there are ones that are realistic, but those are unfortunately not easily controllable. So, does this new technique perform the impossible? Let's see the intro sequence with the new method called diffuse clock and... oh yes! Excellent! This is the best of both worlds, controllable, realistic motion from a soup of data. And here's the best part, it can also do five other amazing things too. One, it can do static obstacle avoidance, so it won't walk into walls. That's a start, but now check this out. Dynamic avoidance too, where you put together a bunch of AI people and they hopefully won't bump into each other when everyone is moving. Let's see. Yep, I think this one checks out. 2, it works for longer animation sequences too. 3, my favorite. Now hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, for generalization. This character only saw jumping sequences on the ground, but now 3 pillars. Haha, let's see if it can do it. 1, 2, 3, excellent. I think this really highlights how powerful these learning methods are. They can do things in ways they haven't seen before. Amazing! 4. It can specify 2 or more poses and it will generate the motion between them. This is not possible with most other diffusion-based AI techniques. 5. Of course, you can grab this character and try to disrupt its movement. With previous methods, this was... well, was it fun? Yes, very fun. Was it disrupted? Oh yes. So, how did the new method do? Now, as you see, it is not perfect, it still looks a bit like someone who had a couple drinks. But it is pretty resistant to these perturbations. Loving this. This is what we researchers do in our work hours, and we call it work, and we even get paid for this. Best job in the world. And this is an incredible leap forward. So, how is all this possible? How did they do all this magic? Dear fellow scholars, this is 2 Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Dr. Carol. So, remember, all this should work from a bunch of unconnected input motions. No information on how to weave them together, no information on how to use these in new situations. No obstacles, no other people. This is all learned behavior. And this new AI is like teaching a dancer not just the steps, but also how to feel the rhythm a few seconds ahead. So every move already anticipates what comes next. The dancer isn't blindly following choreography anymore. No, it can improvise while staying graceful. That's exactly how this system weaves states and actions into one seamless motion. Absolutely incredible! What a time to be alive! And all this is trained on a single GPU in 24 hours, something you can easily do in a Lambda instance and then run it anywhere. And what excites me most is that this is all zero shot. No retraining, no task-specific tuning. Just one model that learns to walk around walls, jump over obstacles, play nice with others, and even respond to a controller. Imagine game characters, VR avatars, or robots that just move naturally out of the box. And this is only the beginning. Just imagine what we will be able to do 2 more papers down the line. My goodness. And I got to say, I can't stop playing with OpenAI's OpenGPT model through Lambda GPU Cloud. And as you see, I am doing very useful things with it. for science. Yes, this is actual speed. I can't believe that I can have more than 100 billion parameters running super, super fast here. Many of you fellow scholars are using it, and if you don't, make sure to check it out. It costs only a couple dollars per hour. Insanity! You can rent an NVIDIA GPU through lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the video description.